This video is about one particular strategy many doctors keep secret from their prostate cancer patients. This strategy is called penile rehabilitation. I don't know why this is, but sexual function is a topic of taboo also in doctors' offices. Not in my office because I have a specialization in sexual medicine. I know this is not a video about enhancement, but it is an important one because prostate cancer is a frequent disease. In the US alone, almost 300,000 men were diagnosed in 2023. So chances are realistic that you might run into a situation yourself where you are confronted with prostate cancer. Then you will have to know what I'm about to tell you, because chances are high that no one will inform you about penile rehabilitation. You will have to know this as early as possible, because the window of opportunity for protecting your sexual function is small. Not only surgery threatens erectile function, but radiation therapy as well. Both treatments will damage your erectile nerves. You need these nerves or else your brain can't signal your penis to function. Let's stick to surgery for a while. How erectile function will turn out mostly depends on several things: your age, your sexual function before surgery, if the erectile nerves could be spared during surgery, and the quality of your surgeon. The body can regenerate. However, nerves regenerate over the course of months to years. Even if surgery was nerve sparing, nerves will suffer. They are very sensitive. You barely touch them and they will stop working. This means you won't have erections for some time. This will result in penile fibrosis. I uploaded several videos on this topic. Here is one of them. The penis will gradually shrink during this process. Not immediately after the operation, that's something different, but on the long run. And you will get venous leakage. I also uploaded videos about that problem. So by the time the nerves regain their function, the penis has suffered from permanent damage. Penile rehabilitation is for counteracting this. There is a generally accepted consensus among urologists that something has to be done and that it has to be initiated early. However, there are no clear guidelines and we don't have enough research to determine the best approach. I think it is safe to say that administering PDE5 inhibitors is the most widely accepted method. It is here everything starts. Because we want to fill the penis with blood whenever possible to protect its anatomical integrity. I usually choose a long-acting drug as tadalafil and start with it at diagnosis when it becomes clear that something has to be done, so the patients get a few weeks with excellent erections. This alone will contribute to an increase in tissue function. The same applies to radiation therapy. Also here, we have some data that show us that long-term administration of Viagra and Cialis protects erectile function. Tadalafil is discontinued only for surgery and is then started again a few days afterwards. Lately, there have been convincing data on the use of a vacuum pump in combination with tadalafil. Before the pump can be started, the healing process will have to be more advanced. Injection therapy is an option to bring about erections. In Germany, we usually use alprostadil. I think in the US, Trimix is more popular. With alprostadil, erections are often painful when administered after radical prostatectomy. As an alternative, I have had some good experiences with aviptadil, which has a different mode of action. Then there are the regenerative therapies. Regenerative therapies have a charming advantage. They have minimal to no side effects. The drawback is, however, that they may not work, because this is a new development in urology. We need 20 more years to come up with high-quality study results. The problem is, if you have prostate cancer now, this doesn't help you. Something has to be done now, not in 20 years. There have been some publications on shock waves with mixed results, but one has to keep in mind that there is no standard. Different treatment protocols administer waves from different machines at different times and different treatment periods with different intensities and different overall energy application. Platelet-rich plasma is a new treatment modality, but we have hardly any data on its effects for penile rehabilitation. Stem cells show promise, but in this area, we still lack scientific evidence. What do I do? I will tell you that in another video. And keep in mind that this video is not medical advice and does not replace a visit to your doctor. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.